Hi, in today's video, we're going to be talking about NuTone apartment house intercom system. Apartment house intercom systems are one of those products that I get a lot of calls about. NuTone started making apartment house entry intercom systems back in the late 1960s, and they were available all the way through the early 2000s, or maybe it was mid-2000s. There were many different models, but the model that's most common nowadays is the model 478, which is this. This is a 478 control amplifier, and the control amplifier is kind of the heart of the system. 478 was also the last model that NuTone made. It originally came out in the late 1970s, and it was in production all the way until the apartment house intercom line was discontinued. So it's the one model that we get the most calls about. I've been trying to figure out the best way to make videos about apartment house intercom systems because they're large, vast systems that, you know, you could have a small system, you could have a building with 4 units, or you could have a building with 150 units. It becomes a large, unwieldy thing to try to deal with. And what I decided to do was I'm going to make several shorter videos instead of an enormously long video and kind of work through it step by step, starting at the beginning with things you need to know and understand, and then moving on to other ones. This particular video, this is the first video in the series. The purpose of this video is to simply explain what the fundamental parts of any NuTone 478 intercom system are and can be, because there is a minimum amount of equipment that you have to have to make the system operate, and then there are some additional things that can be added to a system depending on the features that the building owner wanted when the system was installed. Let's take a look and do an overview of the different parts of what a 478 intercom system would normally consist of. As the heart of the system, we have our 478 control amplifier. And the reason that it's called a control amplifier is because it's not only an amplifier with ring tones and other things built into it, but it also is what controls the system, allows the communication to go two ways and perform other tasks. This is our large enhanced drawing of a 478 amplifier, but let's look at the other parts of the system first. So we have our 478 control amplifier. Of course, we need to power the amplifier. So down here we have a low voltage transformer. And the low voltage transformer that's used on a 478 amplifier system is a NuTone model 301T, which is rated at 16 volts at 30 VA, or for old school guys, 30 watts. And that's the recommended transformer that you should use with the 478 amplifier. Of course, an intercom system of any kind doesn't operate very well if you're not able to actually have stations to talk back and forth. In a normal building with a single entrance, and there are ways that you can have multiple entry systems also, but today we're only talking about the most basic of systems, and most buildings only have one entry. At the main entrance of the building, whether it's into the lobby or some other common space in the building, you're going to have an entry door speaker, and you're also going to have some type of entrance directory. Oftentimes, the entry door speaker is built into the entry door station or directory. You would have a speaker, it's all one metal panel usually, and the speaker will be behind the grill work usually at the top, and then you have a row of push buttons, and the number of push buttons matches typically the number of apartments in the building. So if you have a 4-unit building, you would have 4 push buttons. If you have 12 units, you would have 12 push buttons. If you have 125 units, you're going to have multiple entry panels that go across the wall. I've done buildings where the entrance directory panel is 3 feet wide, and it's got 125 buttons on it. And a lot of those larger ones, usually there's some spot where you can, it has a label behind a piece of clear plastic, and you can write the resident's name in it, and or numbers or whatever. Usually there's always a way to identify them because you have to know which buttons go to which apartment. But regardless, at the entry, you always have a speaker and an entrance directory with push button. And then, of course, in each apartment, you have an apartment station. And the apartment station that works with the 475 control amplifier is the NuTone model N485. And if you have an original version, which would be the late 70s through the very early 80s, it would simply be a 485 speaker, not the N. The N means it was a revision of the original speaker, but they are all interchangeable. And I actually have two videos in our apartment house intercom playlist that shows one how to clean the switches in an N485, and the second one shows how to clean the switches in a 485. So you can look at those and see. If you're working on apartment house intercom systems, there will ultimately be many, many videos in our apartment house intercom playlist that you'll need to or want to watch to learn as much about these systems as you possibly can. That's why they're all grouped together. These are our basic fundamental parts of every system that are required to make a working system. And so as a review, we have our 478 control amplifier. We have our NuTone 301T low voltage transformer to power the amplifier. We have an entry door speaker. We have an entrance directory with push buttons. And we have one N45 apartment station in each apartment. Some of the other equipment that can be included in your apartment house intercom system are, you can have optionally an electric door release. You would think that it would be a default standard thing that you would have in every apartment building, so the resident can simply buzz the door open, as it said, and let someone into the lobby. Although I have worked on buildings where they don't have working door releases anymore. So we're going to call it an optional item, even though I'm guessing probably 95% of all of these systems have a door release. The door release mechanism is in the frame of the, let's say, lobby door, and when a tenant releases it, it energizes and the visitor simply can push the door open and walk into the building. So optional, pretty standard, but let's say it's optional. And while we're talking about door releases, as an optional item that can be added to your 478 control amplifier, it does have the ability to accommodate two door release timers. And the timers were little modules, they're little circuit boards. They are the model, NuTone model 467 is the main door timer, and 4768 is the second door timer for a two entry building. And those go inside the 478 control amplifier, and that's represented here as access slots in the control amplifier housing. That it has little adjustment pots that you can set the amount of time that the door remains unlocked. Without door timers, as soon as the tenant releases the door release switch on the speaker, the door release immediately de-energizes and latches up again. If you have the door timers built in, you can set those, say, to 20 seconds. And when the tenant operates the door release switch on their speaker, it activates the timer, and the timer holds the door release open for the preset 20 seconds, which gives the visitor a better chance to push the door open, and the tenant doesn't have to hold the switch the whole time. So door release timers are always fairly popular. And then the last item, which would be considered an optional item, which you see mostly in older buildings, at least in our area, I don't know how it is in other parts of the country, are what's called a postal lock. A postal lock is a special device that NuTone manufactured, and it is usually a small metal, aluminum metal, rectangular metal frame with a special mount on the back of it. And the Postal Department, the U.S. Postal Service, would supply a special lock mechanism assembly that uses a key that only postal employees have access to. And inside the postal lock assembly is a switch. And so when the postman comes up, he puts his key, special postal key, in the slot in the postal lock and turns it, and it activates the switch that's built into the postal lock. And the postal lock is wired to the control amplifier and then releases the door release. This would be used in buildings where the mailboxes are inside the lobby of the building and the postman needs a way to get in. Postal locks, not every building has them. A lot of buildings nowadays, the mailboxes are on the outside of the building, but that may not be true in all cases or in all parts of the country. So postal locks are an optional item. I would say in our area, probably only maybe 20% of buildings have postal locks. So let's take a second and look at the terminals on our 478 control amplifier. And what we have here, here is a real 478, and here's our terminal switch, our terminal board here at the bottom. And then we have our access slots here, and those are represented in the drawing. This is our terminal board with our wire connections. Those are the red dots. And then up here are some adjustments for the amplifier. So like we talked about, if you have the optional door timers, there's an access here where you can put a screwdriver and turn the pot to adjust the unlock time for the main door timer. And then if you have a second door, this would be the adjustment for that. And again, these are optional items. And then here we have three adjustments for the amplifier itself. Those adjustments are, we have ring frequency. And ring refers to the tone that the system generates when a visitor walks up and pushes a button on the entrance directory. And that tone is generated by the 478 control amplifier. And it's heard not only through the entrance door speaker, but it's also heard in the apartment speaker, so the apartment resident knows there's someone calling to them. Ring frequency adjusts the pitch or tone of it. You can turn it way down, and it's a very low tone, low frequency, not low volume, or you can turn it up and have it be a much higher pitched tone. And most popular is somewhere in the middle, usually. Then you have ring loudness, how loud the ring tone is. It's louder or softer. It's pretty simple. Again, in most buildings at this point, since you're dealing with older systems, wherever those have been set, usually that's where you should leave them. And then you have speaker volume. It's the volume adjustment for the communication between the entry speaker and the apartment speaker. And again, where that is set is probably about right. If it's too high, especially in a lot of apartment buildings, you would be able to hear the conversation in an adjoining apartment because the walls are thin, and so you don't want to make it too loud. Also, you don't want to have it blasting out at the entrance so the visitor gets startled when somebody answers. As for the wire connections on the terminal board, it's all clearly marked on the terminal board what is what. So let's just go through those real quickly, and then I'll show you how things are actually connected up. So if we start down here, we have two terminals for the postal lock connection, and then we have our four intercom wires. We have audio one, audio two, control, and ground. We have screw terminals to connect the lobby speaker. We have screw terminals for the main door release and the second door release if you have two entry doors. You have your 16 volt AC connection, and you have the last terminal here, which is called your ring common terminal. So let's start with the easy things first, and then we'll get into the more complex things. So what we're going to do now is we're going to wire up a 478 apartment amplifier to see if we can make this really posh one unit apartment building actually work. It's really not as complicated as you would think, and let's get started. So since this is a deluxe swanky building, because it only has one apartment and it's probably pretty nice, it would obviously have a postal lock because the mailbox is going to be inside in a swanky building. So you have your postal lock mechanism here, and as surprisingly as it is, the postal lock connections, which are here and here, get wired to the postal lock connections on the terminal board here and here. How hard is that? So all you really would have is a pair of wires. One runs from one terminal and it goes up to one postal lock screw, and the other wire goes from the second postal lock terminal up to the second postal lock screw, like that. Now our postal lock is connected to our 478 control amplifier. See, that wasn't really very hard at all. Of course, to make the 478 amplifier operate, we need to give it some power. From our NuTone 301T transformer down here, which again is 16 volts, we're going to wire this to our 16 volt AC terminals here on our terminal board. So just like we did with the postal lock, it's one wire from each screw terminal connected on, and up, jump over and connect it on here. So now we have 16 volts of power to our control amplifier, and we have our postal lock wired up. Of course, it's not going to do any good unless we're able to talk back and forth, because that's really the whole point of an entry intercom system. So the next thing we need to do is we need to connect our lobby speaker to our amplifier. And it doesn't matter whether the lobby speaker is separate or whether it's built into the entrance directory. It still needs to be wired to the control amplifier. So once again, a wire from each terminal on the door speaker cone. One goes to one lobby speaker terminal, and the other goes to the other lobby speaker terminal. Now our entry door speaker is connected to our amplifier. Again, because this is a swanky building, we have a door release. And we have to wire the door release back to the control amplifier. Since this is only a single entry building, we're going to wire the door release back to the main door release terminal, which is the second set here. In this building, the second door release, those terminals will not be used. Okay, before we actually wire our door release up so we can let the FedEx guy in with something fancy that we ordered, let's talk about door releases and terminal boards on control amplifiers. So here, you can see right here, this is our main door release terminals here, and this is our second door release terminals here. And if you're looking really closely, and you can see, you'll see there's some little device right here that's on these connections, and they're under the screws for the second door release, and that seems to be missing from the main door release. And you might wonder, well, why is that? Or maybe you don't care at all. I'm not sure. Anyway, so let's talk about what that is. This little device right here is a diode. And the diode has a very specific purpose. And you can see here in the diagram, you have a symbol that shows a diode. It's a little triangle. In this case, the pointed end of the triangle is pointed to the right, and then it's connected to each screw terminal. The diodes came standard on the 478 control amplifier, and the purpose of the diode is to take the voltage that comes out of the door release terminals, which is AC, alternating current voltage, and rectify it into a quarter wave of DC, or direct current. So AC is AC, like the wall plugs in your house, and DC is more like a battery where it's plus and minus. The reason you have a diode here and the reason you rectify the AC voltage into DC voltage is because when you do this and you connect this to the door release, here in the door release diagram, you have these red loopy wires. The red loopy wires indicate a coil. It's an electromagnetic coil, and it's what is energized when someone releases the door, and it creates a magnetic force which moves mechanical parts so the person can push the latch past the parts that normally block it and open the door. Most door release mechanisms are designed for DC voltages, voltages that have plus and minus, not AC voltage, which is just AC. If you make the connection between the door release and the main door release terminals here, and you have the diode, you're sending DC voltage to the door release, and the door release is happy. But the byproduct of that is, when someone releases the door, instead of what people are expecting, which I'm sure some of you have heard before, when a door release is released, and let's say when you go to the bank, because this is a place everybody sees it, and the teller or somebody that works at the bank has to go behind through the little door where the vault is and all the tellers are working. So they look over and one of the tellers reaches under the desk and pushes the button and the door they're going to push open goes and then the person pushes the door and walks in. Well, the noise is the sound of a door release energizing, but it's a door release that's being energized with AC voltage instead of DC voltage. If you have DC voltage like you get when you have the diode, all the door release would simply do when it energizes, it would simply go click. And you would just faintly hear the clicking sound. And the clicking sound is actually the mechanical parts inside the door release being pulled out of the way by the electromagnetic force of the coil. And then you would push the door open and walk through. The problem with this is, while this is technically correct to do it this way, it's not what the pizza delivery guy expects to hear when he's being buzzed into a building. He's used to hearing the big noise, and then he knows to push the door open. If it just goes click, and he's not paying attention because, you know, he's a 19-year-old pizza delivery guy, he's going to miss the click, and then he doesn't think the door was opened, was released, and that can be a problem. Even though it's technically correct that you should have a diode across these terminals, in many, many installations, or perhaps most installations, the diode will have been removed. Okay, while it's technically incorrect, it's what people expect. And while removing the diode doesn't damage the control amplifier in any way, it will over time shorten the life of the door release because it doesn't really like AC voltage, but you know, unless you've got 400 people coming and going every day, it's probably not going to make that much difference. That's the deal with the diode. Because we're a real NuTone company, and because we do try to do things the right way, we're going to leave our diode in place. All right, so we need to wire our door release to our control amplifier. And again, all you have to do is you run a wire from one door release terminal to one door release terminal on the control amplifier, and a second wire from the second terminal to the second terminal there. Now our door release is wired up. So at this point, we're getting close to having an operational system. We have our postal lock wired to the control amplifier so the mailman can let himself in and deliver the mail. We have power to our amplifier so it will operate, even though our wires seem to be a little sketchy. That's better. We fixed our wires. How about that? Okay, so we have our power to our amplifier, we have our entry door speaker wired to our amplifier, and we have our door release, oh, with a diode, because I don't like the buzzy noise, wired to our control amplifier also. Now we have to work on, we have the intercom wires to hook back up, and we have our entrance directory wires to hook up. Okay, so the next logical thing to hook up is our entrance directory. Now remember, this is a one-unit apartment building, so we only would have a single button on our entrance directory. We're not going to have five buttons because we don't have five apartments. We only have one, so it's only going to be a single button because, you know, if you live in the swanky one-unit apartment building, you don't want any neighbors bothering you. So we'll ignore the bottom four buttons, and we're going to focus on button number one. And in fact, we're going to label that as apartment number one. So we know. All right. Now we have to look at our apartment station, our N45, and the entrance directory, and our control amplifier. First, we'll look at the apartment station. So on the back of the apartment station, here's the back of an N485. And here we have our speaker cone, just like here. We have our switchboard here. And on the switchboard are our five screws where wires are connected. And we have some green wires that connect the switchboard to the speaker, just like we have here. So the screws on the back of our N485 apartment speaker are labeled as following. You have one screw here, which is the control screw. You have another screw down here, which is the ground screw. We have the top one on the right is the ring screw. And then we have audio one and audio two. On the amplifier, we have a terminal that we have to connect, and it's called ring common. And The ring common is what allows the ring feature on this apartment station to operate when someone pushes the button. So what we need to do is we need to run a wire, but we're not going to run it directly from this terminal, the ring common terminal, to the ring terminal on the speaker, because if we did that, it would ring all the time, constantly, forever, and never stop. And that's not really what we want if we live in the swanky one-unit apartment building. What we want to have happen is when someone comes to deliver something to us, maybe your wife is getting a delivery from Barney's and she's getting that really expensive purse that she bought that cost $1,200. When the delivery guy shows up, you want it to work where he pushes the button for apartment number one and it makes it ring here. So how do we do that? Well, it's not really that complicated. What we're going to do is we're going to run a wire from the ring common terminal on the 478 amplifier and we're going to run it to one side of the push button. These push buttons are the same as any doorbell button on anybody's house. It doesn't matter whether it's a single family home or a townhouse or an apartment entrance directory. It's just basically a doorbell button. In most NuTone entrance directory panels, the buttons are rectangular, and that's why I drew them this way. However, it could also be just a standard round NuTone doorbell button, just like this one. This is a standard replacement. This is a PB18, which NuTone's been making PB18 since the dawn of time. And it doesn't really matter as long as it's a momentary contact push button of some kind, that works fine. You can go down and order a really fancy, expensive one at your door hardware company, or you can go to your restoration hardware and buy a $14 button, or you can order one online from some company that's got a frog and a lily pad on it. It doesn't make any difference. It's just basically a push button. So what we're going to do is we're going to run a wire from our ring common terminal to one side of the push button, like this. And then we're going to run another wire from the other side of the push button to our ring terminal up here. And we're going to take the long way around, like that. All right, so what we've done is, as a review, we've run a single wire from the ring common terminal on our 478 amplifier. We've run it to one side of the push button on the entrance directory for apartment number one, because that's the only apartment in the building. And then from the other side of the push button, we've run another wire from the other screw terminal all the way through the building to the apartment station and connected it to the ring terminal. Now, when the pizza delivery guy shows up, and he pushes the push button here on the entrance directory, it makes a connection inside the button, which essentially is connecting the ring common terminal here to the ring terminal on the back of the speaker, and the ringtone is heard through the speaker inside the apartment. And the frequency of the ring sound and the loudness of the ringtone is adjusted here on our 478 amplifier. And if you've set it up correctly, the people that live there are going to be really happy. Okay, so we almost have a working NuTone 478 intercom system at the moment. And as a short review, we have our postal lock wired to the control amplifier so the mailman can let himself in. And we have the door release wired to the main door release terminals on the amplifier so the postal lock will unlock the door so the mailman can go in and deliver the mail. Of course, we have power from our NuTone 301T low voltage transformer powering the 478 amplifier. And we have our lobby speaker connected up so when we get done with the rest of it, we can actually speak back and forth with the visitor at the entrance. And we have our ring common wire run through the push button on the directory to the apartment station, so when someone pushes the button, you can hear the call or ringtone inside at the speaker. So the last thing we need to hook up is we have to hook up our four common wires that make the intercom system actually operate when you work the controls on the N485 station. So here on the front of the N485 station, it's actually pretty simple. You have this teeter-totter control bar here on the top, And if you push down the right-hand side, it actually says push to listen. So essentially, if you push it down, you can listen to what the person or the visitor is saying at the entrance of the building through the entry door station. And if you push the left-hand side down, it says push to talk. So you push this down to talk back to the guy. So the way this normally would work is somebody will come to the entrance, push the button on the directory. You'll hear the call tone coming out of the speaker here. You would push down the push to talk to ask who's there. And then you would push down the listen side to hear, I'm calling, I'm here from Domino's Pizza to deliver your pizza. And then you would say, oh, that's great, I'm really hungry, let me unlock the door for you. And then you would move the door release switch to door number one, which is on the left, and the door would release and the delivery guy can go into the building. That's how it operates. 478 system is, NuTone called it, it's actually called the System 4 system. And the reason it's called a System 4 system is, that sounds kind of redundant, isn't it? Anyway, it's a System 4 because it has what are considered to be four common wires. The audio 1 and audio 2 and ground and control wires are common throughout every station in an apartment building. Now, our building, our example building, only has one apartment. If we had 5 apartments, a lot of this would be duplicated over and over and over again to accommodate apartment 2, apartment 3, apartment 4, and apartment 5. The audio 1 and audio 2 and ground and control wires are all the same throughout the building. It doesn't matter how many units you have, they all carry the same function, and I'll show you how, when we expand, how that works. So right now, what we need to do, though, since we only have one apartment to deal with, is we need to make connections between these terminals and the matching terminals on the back of the N45. And to make this a little clearer, we're going to use different colors. Oh, and let's talk about colors for a minute. One of the most common things that people tell me when they call looking for answers to the problem or whatever it is they're trying to do is they'll call me up, and it doesn't matter whether it's an apartment house system or a residential intercom system or a NuTone door chime or whatever it is. People always call and tell me, well, I've got these wires, and I've got a red wire and a white wire and a yellow wire and a brown wire and a violet wire and a green wire. Where do those go? And it's like, I don't know. I have no idea where they go. They go where they're supposed to be hooked up. What you have to think about is that the colors of the wires don't make any difference. The way I often explain it to people is the electrons inside the wire, inside the copper part of the wire, the electrons, they don't care what color the wire is. Electrons like yellow wire just as much as they like orange wire, just as much as they like green wire. I don't think they really like violet wire all that much because nobody really likes violet wire. But what are you going to do? They're electrons. So it doesn't make any difference what color wires you have as long as the wires are connected to the right points at each end. If you have a building where Bob the installer used the dreaded violet wire and he ran that between audio 2 and audio 2 over here, it's going to work. You know, if Bob had only had orange wire that day and he ran it between audio 2 and audio 2, it's going to work the same because the electrons don't care what color the wire is. As long as the orange wire is connected to the same points at each end, it's all going to work. The only time you get into trouble when you have to deal with wire colors are when all of the wires are the same color. And I know about that because 25 years ago, I was called out to a building where the intercom system hadn't worked in probably 3 years, and 3 other companies had worked on it before me, and the wiring in the building, and this was a 40-unit building. It's 3 stories, 2 wings with the lobby in the middle, and all of the wires throughout the entire building are brown. There are no multicolored wires. Everything is brown. So whoever wired it should be slapped. Anyway, it took me and my helper Leonard 4 days to sort out and ring out and identify all the brown wires so we know where they all went, so then we could hook it all back up and make it work again. So if you have only one color of wire and you're dealing with hundreds of individual wires, good luck with that. Anyway, let's get back to our one unit swanky apartment building. So we're going to hook up our audio 1, audio 2, control, and ground. Surprisingly enough, our audio 1 wire, which is going to be blue, is going to run from the screw terminal on the 478 terminal board here, and it's going to run through the building, and it's going to hook up, guess what, the audio 1 terminal on the back of the N45 speaker. Now we have to hook up audio 2, and audio 2 is going to be green. So again, we go from the audio 2 terminal on the amplifier, we're going to run it here, and hook it up to audio 2 terminal on the back of that, on the back of the 485. Then we have our control wire, which is going to be the dreaded brown wire. It brings back so many bad memories. Anyway, control on the 478 amplifier to the screw terminal on the N45 for control. And finally, just to jazz it up, we've got a pink wire, because everybody likes pink wire, and that goes from ground to, guess what, the ground terminal on the N45. Now we've completed the wiring for our 478 apartment house entry intercom system for our one unit swanky apartment building. We have everything hooked up. And actually, if you look at your 478 control amplifier, the only thing we don't have hooked up on the terminal board is door release number 2, because we only have a single entry. So now, when someone comes up and pushes the button for apartment number 1, we're going to hear the call tone in the apartment speaker and at the entrance, and then we can operate the controls on the front of the intercom station and ask who's there, and then hear the reply and tell them no thank you very much, and then hear them say but, and then you can push down the talk button and said, if you don't get off my front porch, I'm calling the cops, and that'll be the end of that. If it was someone you were expecting, you could, of course, slide the switch and release the door. That's all there is to wiring up a one-unit apartment building on a NuTone 478 apartment house intercom system. And that seems pretty simple, but now we're going to make it just a little bit more complicated. Okay, so quick, raise number of hands. Raise your hand if you notice what's different now. Okay, so here's what's different. Many years have passed, and the resident and owner of our one-unit swanky apartment building has decided that it's really expensive to live there, and he needs some more income. So he's decided to remodel somewhat and add in and take part of his space and build it into another apartment so he can rent it out and make some cash. As part of the remodel, some things have been added, and the things that have been added are, down here we have another N45 apartment intercom station, and also over here we now have another entrance to the building, which we're going to call door number 2. We need to incorporate the new apartment speaker into the system, and we need to incorporate the new door release for the second entry door, because the swanky guy, he doesn't want to share his entrance with some renter. So, you know, that's how that goes. So this is pretty simple. All we need to do is hook up door release number 2. We're now going to call this door release number 1. We need to hook this up to our control amplifier, and surprisingly enough, you do it the same way. One wire from one terminal, the door release, to the second door release terminal on the 478, and then the second wire to the second terminal. And in this case, we're going to leave the diode in place because the building owner, he doesn't want to hear the rattly noise when the tenant's girlfriend shows up. So it's just going to go click, and that's going to be fine. So now our second door release is wired in. Everything else remains the same, but we still have to wire up the tenant's new N45 down here. How are we going to do that? Well, in theory, you could run wires from the terminals on the 478 terminal board and run them directly to this unit, but that's going to be really, really hard to do in a finished building, and it's not very practical. So what we're going to do is we're going to loop wire, or what's often called daisy chain, the speakers together. And if we remember during my explanation of the audio 1, audio 2 control or ground and control wires, I explained that these are common wires throughout a system. It doesn't matter whether you have just a single apartment speaker, or if you have two apartment speakers, or if you have 125 apartment speakers, these four wires are common throughout the entire building. What that allows us to do is we can take the wires, the connections that are on the back of the original speaker, we have control and ground and audio 1 and audio 2, and we can simply extend those wires. This is the loop wiring or daisy chain part. All we have to do is run wires between these four connections, the four common connections here, from the back of the first apartment to the back of the new apartment, or apartment number 2. And so to do that, we're going to use the same color wires, because we're conscientious installers, and we're going to run the brown wire, we're going to extend it from the control terminal on the first apartment speaker, and we're going to run it down to the control screw on the new apartment speaker. And then we're going to run our pink ground wire from the ground terminal here to the ground terminal on the new speaker. And then we're going to run our audio 1 wire, which was blue, from the original audio 1 terminal here down to the new speaker. And finally, we're going to run our audio 2, which is green, from the audio terminal here down to the audio 2 terminal there. Now our speaker number 2 in apartment number 2 is now connected into the intercom system and will operate exactly the same way as this one does, but they are independent of each other. They will not be able to talk to each other, because that's not how an apartment entry intercom system works, because remember, it's an entry intercom system. It's not an apartment to apartment intercom system. It's an entry intercom system. So now our controls on the front of the N45 will operate correctly. You can talk, you can listen, and you can release the door, but we're missing one thing. How is the person in apartment number 2 going to know that there's someone at the entrance for them, because they're missing the ring wire? There's no ring wire on that speaker, and that's necessary. Otherwise, the button for apartment number 2 isn't hooked up, and it's not going to work. We're going to call this button number 2, like this, and like we did for apartment number 1, we need to run a wire from one side of the button, on the right hand side in this case, from that side of the button to the ring terminal on the back of the speaker. So the button for number 1, the purple wire, runs from this terminal on button number 1 to the ring wire on apartment number 1 station. And so we need to do the same thing down here, which we need to run a purple wire from the right-hand side of button number 2 to the ring wire on apartment speaker number 2. Now, that gets us most of the way there, but we're still missing one important connection. If you remember, to make this operate, we need a wire from the left-hand side of the button to the ring common terminal. Otherwise, it's not connected back to the system. So here, button number 2, it's not actually connected to the system yet, because there's no wire between this side of the button and the ring common terminal. And you might think, well, that's going to be a real chore, because I can't get a wire from here to this screw terminal. Well, you don't have to. The way this is commonly done, because this is a ring, it's a common wire, the way it's normally done is, since it already runs from the ring common terminal on the 478 to the first button, all you have to do is loop a wire from this terminal on button number 1 down to the left-hand terminal on button number 2. And by doing that, the left-hand side terminal or connection on button number 2 goes up to this side of button number 1, which then goes back to the ring comma terminal. So essentially, button number 2 is connected back to the amplifier. And this is essentially how all apartment house intercom systems are wired. The exact method that Bob the installer uses to achieve this will vary a lot from building to building because Bob's got his own way of doing things. He's done a lot of buildings, or he hasn't done any buildings before, and he's a novice at it, but whatever suits Bob is the way it will be done. And as long as the end result is essentially this, it will all operate. Now, I'm going to expand this a little bit for those of you who have sat through all of this. If you remember, as a review, we began with a single apartment in one building. And then we added a second apartment in the building, and we did that by daisy chaining the wires between the original apartment number 1 station and the new apartment number 2 station. Let's say that the building gets renovated and they add 16 more speakers. They create 16 more apartments. All you have to do is duplicate the daisy chain from 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, and so on and so on and so on. And you literally can have the same original 4 wires that are common: audio 1 blue, audio 2 green, ground pink, control brown. Those wires traveling in and out of every apartment in the building, and that will work just fine. The only wires that have to be individual are the ring wires that come from the 14 push buttons on the entrance directory. And those are all on the right-hand side screws. So you would have wires from here that go down to 3, wires from here that go down to 4, wires here that go down to 5, and so on and so on and so on till you have all 14 of them. And to tie the other side of the buttons back to the ring common, all you have to do is loop from button to button to button and continue on to have all of them hooked up. So it's 4 common wires with a ring. That's the way that NuTone guys think of it. Ring wires are individual from one ring wire per each apartment, and all of the other 4 wires are common. That's the fundamentals of how a 478 apartment house intercom system is wired. I hope you found this interesting and perhaps you learned something from it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up on YouTube. If you subscribe to our YouTube channel, then when we post a new video, you'll get a notification through your email to let you know there's something new. If you have questions or comments or ideas about topics for this type of video that you might want to have answered, let me know and I'll see if I can incorporate that into some of the videos also. That's all for today. See you on the next video.